Everybody, Matt Calogli with SRP Medical Marketing and the Warner James Group. And today, what I'm going to do for you is I have been working on a 10 commandments of sorts when it comes to operating your medical practice. And the other day on Monday, today, yeah, Monday, first day back from my vacation, I shared the first one of those, and that is focus on the process. That video has been very well received. And what I decided to do today is I'm going to give you five of the 10. I'm not going to dive in really deep into these, but I am going to give them to you if you would like to go deeper on those. All you have to do is in the comments here and also in the description, I've actually created a LinkedIn group that talks specifically about this. It's called the Income Producing Medical Practice, and you can join that. The reason why I put it on LinkedIn is, quite frankly, I have a lot more doctors and medical professionals on LinkedIn than I do on Facebook, and utilize these Facebook Lives because they're just an easy way to record things. So here's what I'd like you to do. I'm going to walk you through. I've also typed these out, and again, I'm going to go into more detail on those over in that group. So you'll see the link, and again, it's called the Income Producing Medical Practice. And the income, by the way, stands for your income, not someone else's. All right. So let's talk about these 10 rules to 2x your medical practice. Okay. Now, as always, I've created my handy dandy, trusty dusty little green board here. Okay. So you'll see these right here. Let's talk about the first one. I created a video on this. It's been very well received by a lot of people, and that is focus on the process, not the outcome. I had this actual conversation yesterday with one of my, actually two of my medical practices yesterday. Yesterday was coaching day, where I was on the phone with my medical practices for like 30 minutes to an hour, sometimes up to an hour, just working on their plans, talking about the past month and talking about future plans. But this focus on the process is something that is, I recommend that you go back and take a look at the video I did on Monday. I think it's very much dead on, and getting a lot of great positive comments about it. All right, so let's talk about the second one. And that is the second one of run a business, not a practice. What do I mean by that? I'll give you a little taste. Again, I'm not going to go deep into this, but when I talk about running a practice versus a business, or running a business, I should say, not a medical practice. See, the problem is that what I see is that a lot of doctors, they are just focused on running a practice. But how you run a practice is very different than how you run a business. There are metrics that you have to focus in on when you're running a business. There are things that you have to measure on a regular, daily, weekly, monthly basis, and more than just your P&L statement. Running a business means more than just checking your bank balance and feeling good if you have $20,000 in the bank without any understanding of what else is owed. Okay? So you want to run a business. And if you don't know how to run a business, go join my group over on LinkedIn, and I'll dive more into that. Or contact me directly, and we can talk about what that looks like. Okay. Third, you have to have a clear message. And if I were to put a parenthesis around this, you also have that message also would be a clear patient journey. Yesterday, I had a conversation with one of my doctors, and like a lot of you, they do, you know, they'll do some vaginal, they do vaginal rejuvenation, O-shot, P-shot, all of these things, Botox. But where do the roads lead? Okay. So you have to have a clear message about who you are. You got to have a clear message about to your market. We also call it message to market match. The fourth is focus on the 20%. If you have not read or studied the 80/20 principle, the Pareto principle, I suggest you put that on your short list of things to do. I would recommend a book called 80/20 Sales and Marketing by Perry Marshall. I would also recommend a book by Richard Koch, Koch, that talks specifically about the 80/20 principle. Now, what is the 80/20 principle? That is 20% of your actions are going to give you 80% of your outcomes. Now, this is scientific. Vilfredo Pareto was a psychologist or something like that in Italy, and he noticed that 20% of the peas in a pea pod were in 80% of the area. Or I'm sorry, 80% of the pea pods were in 20% of the area. He noticed that 80% of the sunflower seeds in the head of a sunflower were in 20% of the space. And he started noticing this is in nature. Well, if this is in nature, then guess what? It's in life, okay? And since doctors are science-based, the 80/20 principle is science-based. So what does this mean to your practice? Well, 20% of your patients are making you 80% of your revenue. 20% of your procedures are making you 80% of your revenue. Do you know which ones? And so then build a path to take them all there. And then number five, hire experts. Okay. So let me explain this. This does not mean that you have to go out and have the most expensive lawyer or the most expensive accountant. However, you have to realize that you were created to be a doctor, and you've spent a tremendous amount of time being a doctor, and I'm sure you're a very good doctor, or DO, or RA. I understand that there's a lot of different medical disciplines that watch these videos. But here is the, I'm going to tell you a very quick story. I spend a lot of my time around high achievers, and I have been an entrepreneur for 20 years. I constantly, and still to this day, have coaches, not just from a marketing standpoint, but from a business standpoint, that keep me accountable, okay? To this day, I have been playing golf. I'm 51 years old. I've been playing golf since I was six. I've been playing golf for 45 years. I'm a former PGA golf professional. Never played on tour, but I'm a pretty accomplished golfer. I still have a coach, okay? I still have experts around me in every phase of my life. And if you don't have an expert in your business who is helping you, helping guide you in your business, I'm not talking about the procedure side of it. I'm talking about the business side of it. That's an area that you're most likely very weak and not as strong as you should be. You need to either hire experts or put experts on your team or consult with experts, okay? So those are five of my 10 rules. Okay, like I said, I'm going to go into more detail on these in our group over on LinkedIn, and it's called the Income Producing Medical Practice. Again, I put it on LinkedIn because that's just where a lot of my contacts are. Maybe I'll create one on Facebook. I haven't decided, but check it out. I am creating another group of, I'm bringing on another group of core doctors that I'm going to be working with in the month of May. I am looking for four medical practices that want to massively grow their practice in the beginning in the month of May. I'll be telling more of those stories about what we have done and accomplished, like the one practice that we got a 22% increase in profit, 22% increase in profit in the first 60 days. Increased revenues, and all of that revenue increase dropped right to the bottom line. That's just one example. So there you go. Have a great day. Digest these five rules. I'll come out with the next five in the next couple of days. And I look forward to talking to you or seeing you over in our group. Have a good day.